Children, welcome to online class. Children, today in this video class, I will explain you environmental studies, class 2, lesson 2, my school. In my previous video, I have read the full lesson and I have given 46 words, 46 difficult words to underline in your book. Now here, I am going to explain you this lesson. Okay. With the name of this lesson, we can easily understand this lesson is all about the school. Okay. Now first we will see school. Here we will see school, types of schools, different areas of school, people work in the school and celebrations at school. Okay children. Now first we will see school. School is temple of learning. We all go to school to learn and play. Here we learn so many things. We study in classrooms. Our teachers teach us so many things. They tell us a story. We play games and we do lots of fun in the school. Now we will see there are how many kinds of schools. There are three kinds of schools. One is kindergarten. Kindergarten is also called play school. The children below the age of 5 years go to kindergarten. Here in this school, with the help of games, they learn so many things and they are prepared for primary school. Now the next one is primary school. In primary school, children go after the age of 5 years. After the age of 5 years, children go to primary school. Here they learn to read, write, draw and color. And gradually they learn so many things. They learn the environment around them. They learn the areas around them. And they get different kinds of knowledge. After that, here it is secondary school. Children, after completing their primary school, go to secondary school. Now children, how many kinds of schools are there? There are three kinds of schools. Kindergarten, play school, primary school and secondary school. Okay. After this, we will see different areas of school. What is the meaning of different areas of school? Different areas of school means the different parts of school. Different places of school where we go. For example, we go in classroom for study. We go in music room to learn music. We go in the library for reading and for borrowing books. We go to computer lab for computer practicals. Like this, there are so many places. So we will see here the areas of school. Here, the first area is classroom. In classroom, we study. We learn in the classroom. It is the place where we sit. Okay. Now, number two, staff room. A place for the teachers where all the teachers sit together. Number three, library. Library is the place where we go for reading and we can borrow book also. We can borrow book from the library. Number four is music room. Music room. In music room, we go to learn music. Okay. Number five is computer lab. Computer lab. In computer lab, we go for our computer practicals. And like this, there are so many places. There is auditorium also in the school where all the functions are held. And so many places are here, like reception. On reception counter, parents go to submit the fee. Now we will see people work in the school. Now children, all of you understood the different areas of school. Classroom, staff room, library, music room, computer lab. Here we can add garden or playground. Garden and playground. In garden and playground, we go to play, we enjoy, we do lots of fun in the garden and playground. Now we will see the people work in the school. See children,
people. A principal helps us in so many things. He guides the staff members to what to do and how to do. It is the duty of principal to look after the working of the whole school. Now, number two, teachers. Teachers teach us different subjects. They teach us whatever subject they have got, that they teach us. Number three is driver. Driver drives the school bus. Driver drives the school bus. Number four, sweeper. Sweeper cleans the school. It is the duty of sweeper to look after the whole school ground or the whole school environment. It is the duty of sweeper to keep the school campus neat and clean. He cleans our class also. Number five, here we see librarian. Librarian manages the library. He looks after the library. He manages all the books in the library. And we can borrow or we can issue books from the librarian. Now, watchman. Watchman. Children, all of you have seen watchmen on the gate, school gate? Yes, you must have seen. There is always a watchman on the school gate. It is the duty of watchman to see all the visitors and guard the school. Number 7, we will see here, gardener. Gardener looks after the school garden. It is the duty of gardener to look after the school garden. Now children, people work in the school is also over. Now here we have discussed school, type of school, different areas of school, people work in the school, and now we will see celebrations at school. What celebrations we do in the school? Celebrations in the school are many. We celebrate national festivals in school. We celebrate national festivals in school. In national festivals, we celebrate Independence Day. When do we celebrate Independence Day? We celebrate Independence Day on 15th of August. After that, we celebrate Republic Day. R-E-P-U-B-L-I-C, Republic, D-A-Y, Republic Day. We celebrate Republic Day on 26th of January every year. After this, we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti. We celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd of October every year.
Andhera ho gaya tha.
Children, we celebrate Gandhi Jayanti on 2nd of October every year. After these all national festivals, there are some more celebrations that we do in school. For example, we celebrate Sports Day in school. We celebrate Sports Day every year. On the Sports Day, we take part in sports. And there are so many other activities also. And the prizes and medals are given to the winners. After Sports Day, we celebrate Annual Day. We celebrate Annual Day in our school. We have many music and dance programs on this day. And the prizes are given to the intelligent students by the chief guest. After Sports Day and Annual Day, I am writing here. Sports Fourth day, number two, sports day, annual day, we celebrate teachers day, and we celebrate children's day. Okay children, we celebrate Teachers Day on 5th of September every year. We celebrate Children's Day on 14th of November every year. Now children, we learn good manners also in the school. Our good manners show that we care for others. Now let's see some good manners. Always respect our teachers. ALWAYS. Always respect our teachers. Number two is always speak quietly in the class. Always sit quietly, Q-U-I-E-T-L-Y, quietly in the class. The next is always throw garbage in the dustbin. Number three, always throw garbage in the dustbin. Number four, always wish the teacher. Always wish the teacher. And the last one is always be polite to all the children and teachers. Okay children, so these are the manners. These are the manners which we learn. Always respect our teachers. Always sit quietly in the class. These are the good manners. Okay? Always throw garbage in the dustbin. It means do not make your classroom dirty. Okay? And always wish the teacher. Means whenever you are in front of your teacher, you should wish them good morning, good afternoon. Okay? Now these are the good manners. Children, the explanation part of this lesson is over. In this lesson, we have learned school, types of schools, different areas of school, different people who work in the school, and different celebrations in the school. Now, the explanation part is over. In the next video class, I will explain you lesson 3, plants around us. Children, I already have sent you the PDF. You have to do all your work in your notebooks. Children, your notebooks are checked. Tell your parents to collect the notebooks from the